A capacitor is formerly known as a condenser, and prior to that, known as a permittor is a passive two-terminal electrical component that stores electric energy in an electric field. The forms, styles and materials of practical capacitors vary widely, but all contain at least two electrical conductors separated by an insulating layer. Capacitors are widely used as parts of electrical circuits in many common electrical devices. In this video, I will go to show you different types of capacitors. Ceramic capacitor. The ceramic capacitor is a type of capacitor that is used in many applications from audio to RF. Values range from a few picofarads to around 0.1 microfarads. Ceramic capacitor types are by far the most commonly used type of capacitor, being cheap and reliable, and their loss factor is particularly low, although this is independent on the exact dielectric in use. In view of their constructional properties, these capacitors are widely used both in leaded and surface mount formats. Electrolytic capacitor. Electrolytic capacitors are a type of capacitors that is polarized. They are able to offer high capacitance values, typically above 1 microfarad, and are most widely used for low frequency applications, power supplies, decoupling, and audio coupling applications, as they have a frequency limit if around 100 kHz. Tantalum capacitor. Like electrolytic capacitors, tantalum capacitors are also polarized and offer a very high capacitance level for their volume. However, this type of capacitors is very intolerant of being reversely biased, often exploding when placed under stress. This type of capacitors must also not be subject to high ripple currents or voltages above their working voltage. They are available in both lead and surface mount formats. Silver mica capacitor. Silver mica capacitors are not as widely used these days, but they still offer very high levels of stability, low loss, and accuracy where space is not an issue. They are primarily used for RF applications, and they are limited to maximum values of 1000 picofarad or so. Polystyrene film capacitor. Polystyrene capacitors are relatively cheap from a capacitor, but offer a close tolerance capacitors when needed. They are tubular in shape, resulting from the fact that the plate dielectric sandwich is rolled together. But this adds inductance, limiting their frequency response to a few hundred kilohertz. They are generally only available as leaded electronics components. Polyester film capacitor. Polyester film capacitors are used where cost is a consideration as they do not offer a high tolerance. Many polyester film capacitors have a tolerance of 5% or 10%, which is adequate for many applications. They are generally only available as leaded electronics components. Metalized polyester film capacitor. This type of capacitors is essentially a form of polyester film capacitors, where the polyester films themselves are metalized. The advantage of using this process is that because their electrodes are thin, the overall capacitors can be contained within a relatively small package. The metalized polyester film capacitors are generally only available as leaded electronics components. Polycarbonate capacitor. The polycarbonate capacitors have been used in applications where reliability and performance are critical. The polycarbonate films is very stable and enables high tolerance capacitors to be made which will hold their capacitance value over time. In addition, they have a low dissipation factor and they remain stable over a wide temperature range, many being specified from minus 55 degrees Celsius to 125 degrees Celsius. However, the manufacture of polycarbonate dielectric has ceased and their production is now very limited. Polypropylene capacitor. The polypropylene capacitors is sometimes used when a higher tolerance type of capacitors is necessary than polyester capacitors offer. As the name implies, this capacitor uses a polypropylene film for the dielectric. One of the advantages of the capacitors is that there is very little change of capacitance with time and voltage applied. This type of capacitors is also used for low frequencies, with 100 kHz or so being the upper limit. They are generally only available as leaded electronics components. Glass capacitors. As the name implies, the capacitor type uses glass as the dielectric. Although expensive, these capacitors offer very high levels of performance in terms of extremely low loss, high RF current capability, no piezoelectric noise, and other features making them ideal for many performance RF applications. Supercapacitor, also known as a supercapacitor or ultracapacitor, as the name implies, these capacitors have very large values of capacitance of up to several thousand farads. They find uses for providing a memory, hold-up supply, and also within automotive applications. Dear sir, thanks for watching this video. For more updates, please subscribe to our channel, Learning Engineering. And to get a notification, press the bell icon.